platform. So I welcome you all to this core booster series of BARC examination. So how are you all? Yes. So we'll be continuing our topic of the three subjects combining together: theory of machines, heat transfer and mechanics. So we'll be discussing important questions related to your BARC examination, and I hope so all of you are attempting the quizzes, and all of you are downloading the quizzes which are provided by the GradeUp. Okay, because in the GradeUp app you can get some quizzes also which you can practice for your examination. Very good evening, Vaibhav and PM. So how are the preparations going on? I hope so it's all good. Adarsh, Chanchal, very good evening all of you. I'm good. Ashish, yes. So practice some question. And one more thing I'd like to announce, like those who have not yet installed GradeUp app, they can install GradeUp app, because the GradeUp platform, you can get some quizzes. Okay, apart from this, you can get some quizzes so that you can practice more number of questions before going into the exam hall. Okay, fine. I'm good. All of you, I welcome you all to this live session of BARC examination score booster series. Let us start today's session. Okay, let us start today's session. This is about myself. My name is Suraj Gopi. As you all know, 5+ years of teaching, but this is my area of expertise, my subjects which I'm taking. Now, let us quickly start today's session. Let us start the first question. Now, you'll be solving with me because these are very important questions, exam point of view. Yes, now let us understand the question. The following data related to a single cylinder reciprocating engine, the mass of the reciprocating engine is given 40 kg, speed is given 150 rpm. Your stroke is given as 350 mm. Then unbalanced force when the crank has turned 45 degree from the top dead center when 60 degree of the reciprocating part is to be balanced. Yes, quickly tell me. Quickly solve it. This is a question from the unbalanced from theory of machine topic. You have to solve quickly. It's a very basic thing. Fine. You first of all, calculate omega. Omega, you can calculate 2 pi n by 60. You can calculate omega by 2 pi n by 60. Now, how to calculate the net unbalanced force? There's a direct formula. Anyone who remember, please solve it quickly. Same to you, Abhinash. Quickly solve it. What is a net unbalanced force? What is a net unbalanced force which you can calculate? Yes, anyone who has solved the problem, we are having a very good number. So I need answer from you all, guys. Tell me what is the correct option. Read the statement carefully and tell me what is the net unbalanced force which is being exerted. Please make sure you are taking, you have to take only 60% of the reciprocating part. That means your C is equal to 0.6. Remember, C is equal to 0.6. The net effective force, the net unbalanced force will be 1 minus C mr omega square sine theta whole square plus C into mr omega square cos theta whole square under root. So I got one answer from Akhil. Okay, very good. Let us check whether your answer is correct or not. Yes, I want answer from your guys. Ashwin, yes, that is only one force. We need to calculate what is the net effective force. Okay. Anyone else who has solved this problem? It's a very basic thing. First of all, you will be calculating omega. Omega is 2 pi n by 60. N is 150 rpm. So when you solve it, you will be getting 15.7 radian per second. 15.7 radian per second. After this, you will be calculating. Now, a stroke is given 350 mm. What will be the radius of the crank? What will be the radius of the crank? 440.3. Okay, Chanchal, let us check whether your answer is correct or not. Shivraj, okay. C is the unbalanced force. Okay, now tell me what is the radius. It will be L by 2, half of the stroke length. So it is 175 mm. Please make sure in the question what they are asking, what is the unbalanced force. That means they are asking what is the total unbalanced force. There will be two unbalanced force along the line of stroke and perpendicular to the line of stroke. So you have to take both into the consideration. I got one answer from Indra Patel and he is correct. I've got only one correct answer from Indra Patel. Now, you got omega, so you'll be having net unbalanced force. Net unbalanced force is equal to, because we're having two unbalanced force, one is perpendicular to the line of stroke and one is along the line of stroke. So it will be having under root of 1 minus C into MR omega square sine theta. Remember the formula? MR omega square cos theta whole square plus C into MR omega square sine theta whole square. The complete under root. This is the total unbalanced force. Fine. C value is 0.6. It's already given in the problem because you need to balance only 60% of the reciprocating parts. Yes, tell me, what is the correct answer you're getting? Very good, Bhavesh, Ajay Chaurasia. Very good. I got three answers. I got correct answer from Bhavesh, Indra and Ajay Chaurasia. Anyone else who has solved this problem? So this is the total unbalanced force. So total unbalanced force is 1 minus C, that is 1 minus 0.6 into, you can take common MR omega square because this is complete square. This is cos. Now you have to calculate at theta equal to 45. So this is cos 45 whole square plus 0.6 into sine 45 whole square under root into, you can take common as MR omega square. Solve it and tell me what is the correct answer quickly. Yes, very good, Vignesh. You can see the data which is given. We are having mass equal to 40 kg. Your omega is already calculated, which is 15.7 radian per second. Radius is 175. Just need to place the values of all this data over here. You'll be getting the correct answer. Very good, Vignesh. You'll be getting approximately 880.7 Newton. So I suppose option B is the correct answer. Yes, very good. Avinash, correct. Very good. Option B is the correct answer. Very good. Chetan Patil, correct. Your answer is correct. Shivraj, Akhil, Chanchal, please check your answer because you have taken, I suppose, only one force. In this question, you have to consider both the unbalanced force, that means perpendicular to the line of action of stroke and parallel to the line of action of stroke. So that is why I am considering both the unbalanced force. You have to take the under summation of resultant of both the forces. You'll be getting 880 Newton approximately. Is that clear? Hello, Sujika, and happy Holi to you also. So this is the first question. Let us discuss the second question, because second question is a very important problem. Please read the question carefully and try to solve the problem. A riveting machine is driven by a motor of 3 kilowatt. The actual time to complete one riveting operation is 1.5 seconds and it absorbs 12 kilonewton meter. The moving parts, including the flywheel, are 220 kg at 0.5 meter radius of gyration. Determine the speed of the flywheel immediately after riveting if it was 360 rpm before riveting. Now, you have to calculate what is the omega, omega 2. Basically, you have to calculate what is omega 2 after riveting. So, before riveting, we are having omega 1 as 360. You have to convert into radian per second. You have to calculate what is omega 2. Quickly try to understand the problem. Yes. Now, I'll be asking you a few questions in this problem. First of all, tell me how much amount of energy is absorbed by your riveting operation. Tell me. Or how much energy is required for one riveting operation? Anyone who can tell me, read the statement and tell me how much energy is required for completing one riveting operation. So I can write directly energy required per riveting. Tell me what is the energy required for one riveting operation. What is the energy required for one riveting operation? Read the statement of the question, then only solve the problem. What is the application of flywheel? Very good, Saurav, you are correct. Flywheel is basically, it's used whenever we are having fluctuation of energies. 37.6 Neeraj, okay. Omega. Fine. Okay, you are getting approximate answer. Look, energy required will be having 12,000 Newton meter, because just read the statement. To complete one riveting operation, it absorbs 12 kilo Newton meter. That means the energy required for one riveting operation is 12,000 Newton meter. Is that clear? Fine. Now, tell me from the motor, how much energy is being supplied? Tell me. If I talk about energy supplied by motor in one second, the energy supply is 3000 Newton meter. In 1 second, the motor is supplying 3000 Newton meter. But in our case, what is the duration of operation of one riveting? Can anyone tell me what is the time duration for completing one riveting operation? So it's 1.5. Fine, it is 1.5 seconds. So from the motor, how much energy is being supplied by the motor? So motor is supplying, basically, if you write energy supplied by motor in 1.5 second is equal to 3000 into 1.5. Fine, this is 4500 Newton meter or joule. Manpreet, your answer is correct. Very good, Vikash, Manpreet, both of you are correct. Fine, so please understand the problem. So basically, what is happening, for completing the riveting operation, you require 12,000 joule of energy, but motor is supplying only 4500 joule. So what is the rest amount of energy will be supplied? It will be supplied by the flywheel. So we can directly write, so delta E is equal to 12,000 minus 4500. Fine, what is delta E? Half I omega 1 square minus omega 2 square. That is a fluctuation of energy. That is equal to your 12,000 minus 4,500. Is that clear? What is omega 1? Omega 1 is already given, because before riveting, it was rotating at 360 RPM. So this will be 2 pi into 360 by 60. So this will be basically 12 pi radian per second. Fine. And your I is equal to mk square. Mass already given in the problem is, mass is 220 kg. Mass is 220 kg and radius of gyration is 0.5. So this will be 220 into 0.5 square. 220 into 0.5 square. Just you need to place every value, you'll be getting omega 2 from this expression. Everything we have calculated, omega 1 we have calculated, I is mk square. So you'll be getting approximately 33.89 radian per second. Fine. Yes, very good. Exactly. You are getting exact answer. Very good. Saurav, Satyarth, Sony, correct. Vignesh, Piyush, Mittal. Exactly, very good. The answer is basically given in radian per second. Answer, this is given in radian per second. Okay, so all these answers in radian per second. So correct answer is 33.89. Very good. Option is the correct answer. Understood? The question, such type of tricky questions you can expect in BARC examination. So it's better you can have a practice on these kind of sessions. Is that clear? So option A, 33.89. is the correct answer. Any doubt, if you're having, please tell me, or we can go for the next question. 33.89 is the correct answer. Okay, let us move to the next problem. Very good, Deepak, your answer is correct. 33.89 radian per second. Let us move to the next problem. Carbon steel balls initially at 150 degrees Celsius are quenched in an oil bath at 20 degrees Celsius. for a period of 3 minutes. If the balls have a diameter of 5 cm and convective heat transfer coefficient is 450 watt per meter square degree Celsius, the center temperature of the balls after quenching will be. It's a basic question from transient heat conduction. It's a very easy direct formula based question from transient heat conduction problem. So tell me what will be the correct option. No, just you are only 2 questions late and we have discussed one important problem, Rashad. So you can see after this lecture, the second question, it's a very important problem, BARC exam point of view. Yes, tell me, you just need to apply direct formula, which is your transient heat conduction formula. Because when you will be calculating Biot number, it will be less than 0.1. That means it is a lumped body. Fine. You can cross check also, or else you can directly calculate by using the formula, which is T minus T infinity upon T initial minus T infinity is equal to e to the power minus HA by rho into V into CP into time T. Yes. What is the correct answer? Just use your Calci, directly feed the values and tell me what is the temperature after quenching is done for 3 minutes. Very good, Manpreet. Very good. Your answer is correct. And Manpreet is consisting. I want everyone to please respond quickly. Manpreet, you are correct. And he is always consistent in solving the problem. Very good. Arpit Mathur, very good. Correct. Bhavesh Patil, correct answer. Chetan Patil, Patil, correct. Yes, very good. So, I hope so you have understood. Just need to place, you have to calculate the temperature T. What is the ambient or surrounding temperature? It is 20 degrees Celsius upon initial temperature is 150 minus 20 is equal to e to the power minus what is area by, or we can say, what is the ratio of volume by area for a sphere? Because it's a steel ball, it's a sphere. That means 4 by 3 pi r cube upon 4 pi r square. So this is basically r by 3. So instead of v by a, you can write r by 3. Fine. So you can directly write h into 3 by rho into v into r into t. And make sure you are taking the value of t in SI units. It's given in 3 minutes. Just convert the 3 minute into second. 3 into 60. That will be 180 seconds. Okay, make sure you are taking the value of T in seconds, or else you'll be getting a wrong answer. Okay, so all the values is given. H value is 450. Your density is given as 7830. Velocity is given. Oh, sorry, not velocity. It's volume into CP. It's CP. CP is given as 434. R value, radius is given as the diameter is already given. Yes. Radius is given as 2.5 centimeter. So you'll be getting temperature is equal to 27.6 degrees Celsius. So after 3 minutes, the temperature of carbon steel balls will be 27.6 degrees Celsius. Okay. Option A. Yes, correct. Those who are responding, those who are getting approximately 27.6 is correct answer. Very good. Very good. So those Rashad, Ajay, Adarsh, Saurav, Neeraj, all of you are correct. Just you need to do some calculation. That's it. Your answer is correct. Option A. Done. Can we move to the next problem? Because I want some questions to be solved. And these are very, very important problem from BARC exam point of view. Because you won't be getting a one-liner in BARC examination, please make sure that you'll be getting some calculating problem or numerical problem. Yes, next question from again from the heat transfer. In a figure shown, it's a conical section is fabricated from pure aluminium having thermal conductivity K, 236. It is a circular cross-section having a diameter of D is equal to 0.5 x power 1 by 2. The small end is located at x equal to, that means x1 is equal to 25 mm. And x2 is equal to, I suppose, 125 mm. You need to calculate what will be the heat transfer rate in x direction. That means only in the x direction. Fine. Physical significance of lump, lumped body is that body basically. If I say this body is a lumped body, that means the temperature will be same at each and every point at every instant. If I say the temperature at starting is 10 degree, the 10 degree will be at the each and every point on the surface. After 1 second, if the temperature is 9 degree, that at each and every point the temperature will be 9 degree. That is the significance of lumped body. Lumped body is that body which whose Biot number is less than 0.1. Now calculate what is the heat transfer. Calculate the heat transfer, where it's a direct formula from Fourier's law of heat conduction. You need to apply, I'm giving you one hint, you need to apply Fourier's law of heat conduction equation for calculating the heat transfer formula. Now in this case, area is constantly changing, so you need to integrate the equation, get a equation, you will be getting a logarithmic equation. That means the temperature will be varying logarithmically with respect to x. That means it will be having a variation something like this. If this t is on y axis, we have t, on the x axis we have x, so this is with a logarithmic variation. Nitish Patel, sir, my brother selected in ISRO examination having AR1, very good, congratulations. And NASA scientist, what will be in the starting phase, he'll be getting 50 to 60 in that range, fine. Or 45 to 55. It's basically written on the website also. You can see when the notification is done, the salary structure is also given. Okay, Nitish. you'll be having many cost cuttings also. So you can directly watch. Approximately, you'll be getting 45 to 55 in between that only. Okay, so I got one answer from Vikas and Arpit. And both of you are correct. Very good. Yes, quickly solve it. Tell me what is the correct answer. Now, in this case, you need to apply Fourier's law of heat conduction because it's only is acts in x direction. So Qx is equal to minus k into area into del t by del x. Del t by del x. Okay. Now, if I talk about it, this minus k, area will be pi by 4 into d square. D is 0.5 into x to the power 1 by 2 whole square. Is that clear? Into del t by del x. This is qx. Fine. Just rearrange the equation. Just rearrange the equation. We'll be getting minus k pi by 4. This will be 0.5 whole square. This will be x del t by del x. This is qx. Just rearrange the statement. This is del t is equal to minus 4 by k pi. 4 by k pi into 0.5 square into x dx integrated. Now tell me what will be the limits. Option C, yes, correct. Adarsh, Saurav Agarwal, you are correct. Indra Patel, correct. Vignesh, correct. Now what will be the limits? This is from x1 to x2, and at x1 we are having temperature T1 to T2. Fine. So when you integrate this equation, you will be getting, let us suppose this is the equation, del t t1 to t2 is equal to k into 4q by k pi x dx into 0.5 whole square x1 to x2. This is T1 minus T2. I'm taking the negative sign inside. This is 4Q upon K pi ln x, x1 to x2 into 0.5 square. So we'll be having Q is equal to K into pi into 0.5 square by 4 upon ln x2 by x1 into t1 minus t2. So this is the final expression, and place the value and tell me what is the correct answer. I'm good, Kuldeep. So you'll be getting approximately 5.76 kilowatt. Option C, I suppose. You'll be getting option C. Your x1 and x2 limits are from 25 to 125. Okay, 25 to 125. Make sure you are, no need to convert into meter because the ratio is given. So x2 by x1 will be cancelling out, the mm will be. So we'll be getting approximately 5.76. Option C is the correct answer. Is that clear? Option C is the correct answer. Very good, Akshay, Neeraj, Saurav, Manpreet, Mahinder, Sirvi, correct. Let us move to the next question. I hope so. Now you understood, whenever you are having a variable cross section, you need to approach by a very basic concept. That means you need to apply the Fourier's law of heat conduction. Next question. Consider a 1.5 meter high and 2 meter wide triple plane window, the thickness of each glass layer. Basically, we are having a window in which we are having 3 layer of glasses, and in between the layer of glasses, we are having a layer of air. Fine. So something like this, we are having a glass, then air, then glass, then air, then again glass. So this is the complete window. That means they are saying a triple plane window. Having a K value is given and the thickness is 0.5. This is 0.5 and this is 1 centimeter. If the inner and outer surface temperature is 10 degree and 0 degree, calculate the rate of heat loss through the window. Very basic question. Calculate the rate of heat transfer. Very basic question. Tell me how many number of resistance will be there. First of all, tell me the very basic question. How many number of resistance will be there? Quickly, sir, kya SSCJ ki classes 2020 mein continue rahengi ya SSCJ 20? No, it will be continued. Okay, this is still the SSC exam. Then we'll be having other schedule for you guys. We'll be having 5 resistors. Very good, because we'll be having 5 interface. That is your glass, air, glass, air, glass. We're having 5 layers of resistance. We are not considering convection. Please make sure you are, because there is no temperature of air. It is basically given the temperature of the surface. 10 degree and 0 degree as the temperature of the surface. That means only 5 resistance are given. You need to apply a very basic formula, that is L upon Ka. Your resistance will be is equal to L by Ka. That will be the resistance. You need to calculate for glass. You need to calculate for air. L by Ka. Add it. Your formula will be Q is equal to T1 minus T2 upon total resistance. What is total resistance? R total will be 3 of RG plus 2 RA. Very basic. Okay, please solve it. We are having 5 glass resistance, 2 air resistance. Need to add, because these all resistance are in series. You'll be getting the answer. Very good. Your answer is correct. Yes, I got first answer from Vikas. Correct, Vikas, Maheshwaran, Avinash, Indra Patel, Avinash, Mule, Upendra, correct. Chetan Patil, correct. How to get the value of RG? RG is equal to L upon Ka. For RG, we are having 0.5. So this is 0.005. L upon K. K value for glass is 0.8 into area. What will be the area? Area is, now we are having height is equal to 1.5 meter and inside the board we are having a width of 2 meter. Fine. So your area will be 1.5 into 2. Is that clear? And RA is equal to, that is air is equal to, the thickness is 1 centimeter, that is 0.01 upon, it is 0.025 into 1.5 into 2. So you have calculated for 1 layer, 3 layers of glass, 2 layers of air. That will be your total. T1 is 10 minus 0. Tell me what is the answer. We'll be getting option D, 37 watt. Exactly, you'll be getting 36.639 watt. So you can directly take it as 37 watt. Option D is correct. Vaibhav correct, PM correct. Sir, ye bar ki classes kitne baje se hoti hai? Exactly at 5:15 everyday classes are going on, but today is the last class for bar. You can check out the complete playlist for all the subjects. You can revise it. Clear? And we are also coming up with Weizsäcker steel also, so you can stay connected with us. In the later on classes, we'll be having, in the later on days, we'll be having Weizsäcker steel classes also. For that, you can have a preparation for the Weizsäcker steel. So the correct answer is 36.6. That means approximately 37 watt is the correct answer. Very good, all of you. Those who have responded option D is the correct answer. Clear? Can we move to the next question? Let us move to the next question. Okay. The sum of magnitude of two forces acting at a point is 16 Newton. Okay, now this is a very basic question. If the resultant is normal to the smaller force and has a magnitude of 8 Newton, then the forces are. Please tell, please calculate quickly. This is a question from mechanics, very basic. Thank you, Chetan, because we need to help our students, grade up students also, not grade up students also, because we need to focus that every students need to be clearing the exam. For that, we are launching different series for you guys only. So try to get the advantage of that series. Fine. So let us try to solve this question. There are two forces. Let us suppose the force A and B. There are two forces A and B whose resultant R is already given 8 Newton. Okay, and the sum of these, that is A plus B, is given as 16 Newton. Now, there is one statement given as, if the resultant is normal to the smaller force, let us suppose the smaller force is A, this is your resultant R, and this is your force B. Let us suppose the angle between the two forces are theta, and this angle is 90, this alpha is equal to 90 degree. Tell me, calculate. Mohammad Rahman, yes, very good. I got answer from Maheshwaran, correct. Your answer is correct. Mohammad Rahman, Rehan, correct. Quickly solve it. Now, what is tan alpha? Remember, tan alpha, the angle which the resultant is making with the horizontal, that is tan alpha. This is basically is equal to B sine theta upon A plus B cos theta. Remember, now what is the value of alpha? Alpha is equal to 90. That means your tan 90 tending to infinite. What's the meaning of this? That means your A plus B cos theta is equal to 0. If A plus B cos theta is equal to 0, next formula which you can use is R square is equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. Theta. Fine. What is R? R is already given 8. So you can write directly 64. 64 is equal to A square plus B square plus. Now instead of B cos theta, I can write minus A. This is minus A. That is minus 2A square. So we are having B square minus A square is equal to 64. So you can write B minus A into B plus A is equal to 64. Now B plus A is already given in the problem. This is equal to 16. So B minus A is 16, 64 by 16, that is 4. And B plus A is already given as, B plus A is already given as 16. It is 16. So add and subtract, you'll be getting B is equal to, when you add this, you'll be getting B is equal to 10 and A is equal to 6 Newton. So which of the option is correct? Option A is correct. Yes, option A is the correct answer. 6 Newton and 10 Newton. Clear? Yes, 6 Newton and 10 Newton. Very good, Harshit. Ajay Chaurasia, very good. Fine. Understood? Akshay Oswal, correct. You will be getting A equal to 6 and B equal to 10 Newton. I have given you the solution for the same. Very good. Option A, way above, correct. Try to solve the question by yourself because time is also very limited in the BARC examination. You need to improve, you need to speed up your calculation and also you need to understand the logic also. Kuldeep Datta, very good, correct answer, option A. Let us move to the next question. A four-stroke cylinder, single cylinder IC engine running at 600 RPM, again from a theory of machine topic, has a connecting rod of length 150 meter and crank of 60 mm. What is the maximum shaking force created by the engine if the mass of the reciprocating parts is 2.5 kg? Yes, quickly solve it. Maximum shaking force. What is the maximum force? What is the unbalanced force? It is mr omega square cos theta plus cos 2 theta by n. Remember, it is mr. I'm writing the formula. Maximum shaking force is equal to, or vibration is equal to, shaking force is equal to mr omega square cos theta plus cos 2 theta by n. This is the formula, remember. Fine, we are having primary and the secondary. What is that alpha angle made by force A? This is the angle. This is basically, if this is force A, this is force B. In between the forces, we are having angle theta. Let us suppose we are having a resultant in this direction, and the angle made by this force with this is alpha. The angle made by the resultant, that is alpha. Okay. Now, back to this problem. Tell me, if I want to calculate what is the maximum force, what is the maximum force? What will be the value of theta? Quickly tell me. What will be the value of theta? Theta will be equal to Ankita Gupta. Yes, very good, Harshit. Please check your answer, Ankita. Ankita, yes, correct. Ankita, your answer is correct. Yes, I was getting, yes, 829 is correct. Harshit, Ankita, Ajay, very good, correct. So theta will be equal to 0, then only we'll be getting the maximum force. So this maximum, or F max, will be equal to mr omega square 1 plus 1 upon n. Now, what is n? It is obliquity ratio, which is L by R. What is the length of the connecting rod? That is 150. And what is the radius of the crank? This is 60. So we'll be getting this as to be 2.5. So n is equal to 2.5. Mass is already given. Mass is 2.5 kg. R is, what is R? Yes, what will be the value of R? Tell me. It is 0.06 given. Fine. So if I place this, your mass is 2.5. Radius is 0.06 into omega. You have to calculate. Omega is equal to 2 pi n. N is 600 RPM. So 600 by 60. So this will be 20 pi radian per second. 20 pi radian per second. Place this value. This is 20 pi whole square into 1 plus 1 upon 2.5. Solve it and tell me what is the answer you're getting. You'll be getting option B, A29.05. Very good. Mohammed Yasser, correct. Or option B is correct. Kuldeep also correct. Very good. Omega, you'll be getting 62, I suppose. Yes. Omega is 62.83. Yes. If you calculate this, 62.83, because pi is 3.14 into 2, 62.83. Very good. Option B is the correct answer. 829.05 Newton force is being exerted, or that is the net shaking force on the engine of the reciprocating part. Okay. You'll be getting this as 62.8 radian per second. 20 pi. Pi is 3.14. Understood. Can we move to the next problem? Okay, next problem. Yes. Air at 363 Kelvin and 1 atmospheric flows over a flat plate at a velocity of 30 meter per second. If air has your dynamic viscosity of 2.13 into 10 per minus 5, calculate the thickness of the boundary layer at the distance 2.5 centimeter from the leading edge of the plate. Yes, you have to calculate what is the thickness of boundary layer delta. You need to calculate. For that, you need to understand what is the type of flow. So first of all, calculate what is the type of flow. Calculate the Reynolds number. First of all, calculate the Reynolds number, because without understanding the type of flow, you cannot calculate the thickness of boundary layer. So calculate what is the Reynolds number. Reynolds number is equal to rho v x by mu. Now, density is not given. How to calculate density? Density is not at all given in the problem. How to calculate? Some other parameters is given. Pressure is given, and I suppose temperature is also given. How to calculate density? Yes, correct. Harshit, correct answer. Density, how to calculate density? You can use Jarrett formula. Density is equal to P by RT. Density is equal to P by RT. Fine. Pressure is 1 atmospheric, that is 10 to the power 5 converted to SI unit. What is R? R, you will be taking it as 287 into temperature is 363. You will be getting density as approximately 0.9599 kg per meter cube. Okay, this is the density which you are getting. Okay. Yes, ideal gas equation, PV is equal to NRT or PV is equal to MRT. Fine, very good, Vasudevan and PM. You'll be getting, yeah, now you got the value of density. Now tell me, what is the type of flow? What is the type of flow? Is it a laminar flow or turbulent flow? Because this is a flow or flat plate, tell me what is the type of flow. So density, you got the value, velocity is already given 30 meter per second, x is 2.5 converted into meter, mu is already given. You will be getting Reynolds number as 33798. You'll be getting 33798. Tell me, is it a turbulent flow or a laminar flow? Rashad, Arpit, very good. This is not a flow or this is not flow through pipe. This is flow over flat plate. Whenever we are talking about flow over flat plate, what is the critical Reynolds number? It is 5 into 10 to power 5, which is less than this. Fine. So it is a laminar flow. It is not a turbulent flow. Please make sure that it is a laminar flow, because for plates, your Reynolds number, if it is less than 5 into 10 to power 5, that is your laminar flow. And in this case, it is coming out to be a laminar flow. 2000 is basically for flow through pipe. Now, this is not pipe. This is over a flat plate. So, it's a laminar flow. If it is a laminar flow, you can use a very basic equation, Blasius equation. Okay, Blasius equation, which is delta is equal to 4.64x by REx under root. Fine. Basis equation you can use. So this is 4.64 into 0.025 upon under root of 33798. Tell me, what is the answer you're getting? It should be approximately, if I convert into mm, 6.31 mm. If I convert into mm, you'll be getting approximately 6.3 mm. Okay, fine. So it is 0.63 mm. So option C. The closest answer is option C. Let us suppose if this would have been a turbulent flow, then what should be your approach? Okay, you got the answer. This is your laminar flow. You have used the Blasius equation. Now, if this would have been a turbulent flow, then what will be the equation? Because you need to understand the other part also. If this would have been a turbulent flow, you need to use a basic equation, 0.386 upon RE power 1 by 5. Fine. So this is the expression for turbulent flow. But as this is not a turbulent flow, we can directly use. Yes, so some of the cases, you can take 5x. Instead of 4.64, you can use 5x. You will be getting exactly 6.26. I'm not using the approximate solution, I'm using the exact solution. Fine. So you'll be getting 0.63 as a correct answer. Okay. Sometimes Blasius equation, for easy calculation, you can use 5x, no problem. You will be getting approximately 6.34, something like that. It's a partial. It's a partial. Fine. When you are deriving momentum equation, you are getting this solution of the delta. Fine. Yes, you can use 5 also. Fine. You can use 5 also. No problem with that. You'll be getting approximately 0.6C. Ultimately, the answer which you are getting will be option C. Is that clear? Fine. Understood? Okay. Fine. So, thank you. So, this is... if you are using 5, then we are getting 0.67. Yes, your approximate answer is option C only. How will I increase my accuracy and speed? My dear friend Rashad, you can only increase your speed by attempting more number of questions. Okay, so that what you can do, you can come, you can open GradeUp app. In that you are having some questions, you can solve some practice problem before going into the examination. Okay, any exam. Fine, because the speed will only be improved if you are solving more number of problems. Okay, you all of the students have understood the concept. Now it's a time for the application of that concept that only can be done by solving the problem. If you are not solving the problem, if you are only solving one or two questions, that is not sufficient for any examination. If I talk about PARC, if I talk about GATE, if I talk about ESE also, okay. In BARC examination, calculators are allowed. So, please solve these type of question using the calculator. Clear? Now, this is it from my side. If I talk about the course which we have launched, we can use CALCIN GATE exam. Yes, you can use CALCIN GATE examination. Okay? You are having a virtual calculator. You need to understand. There is a video in YouTube by the GradeUp team. You can search it. It's how you can use virtual calculator. Okay, now if I talk about our course Vision 2021, this is after the successful launch of the batch 1. We have again started for batch 2 for a complete 1 year course for GATE and ESE aspirant, that is for 2021. Okay, so it will be highly beneficial for all the job going aspirants or the college going student, because the classes are basically occurring in the evening. Classes are basically occurring in the evening classes, and every day you'll be having a separate quiz for GATE level and ESE level that makes an extra edge for other platforms. Okay, fine. And your paper 1 also will be covered. It's a complete package for ESE as well as GATE according to the new pattern. If I talk about the timing, it is basically from 7 to 9 p.m. the first class, and the second class at 9:30 to 11:30 p.m. And these classes will be occurring Monday to Friday, and every day you'll be having 5 quizzes from GATE level for your practice and 5 quizzes ESE level related to that topic which you have studied in that particular classes. Okay, like if suppose in today's class you have studied if in today's class you have studied boundary layer, so you'll be having questions, 10 questions from boundary layer only. Will the English, yes, it's all classes are in English. Okay, make sure all the classes will be held in English language only. How many days we can get free trial? Approximately 2 weeks. Now we are having a free trial also, you can get used to it. And now the classes are not going on due to the holy vacation. The classes will be resumed by Thursday. You can come again on Thursday. You can come to the app. You can enjoy the live free classes at the same timing, 7 to 9. And at present, fluid mechanics going on. You can come and join the classes. It's for free only. I'm not saying directly for course purchase. You can first understand. If it is relevant, you can go for the purchasing. Now, if I talk about the your scholarship, this is the scholarship which you are providing for GATE qualified students, for IIT and IIT BTech students, and ESE prelims qualified. For more information, you can contact this number. I told you, for every examination, you need to practice more number of questions. So, Green Card is a one-stop solution for all the problems. You'll be having a bunch of problems, subject-wise, full-length problems. You can have an access. You can go for yearly or monthly card. And this is a sale which is going on, 30% off. I basically deal with mechanics, heat transfer, and theory of machine. This is the three subjects which I am dealing with, Rahman. Is there any mock? Yes, we'll be having mock interview also for the ESE aspirants. We'll be having a, we can say, expert panel group who will be taking mock interview. Those who are qualified for the mains examination. Those who are qualified for the mains examination, they'll be having mock interview practice, because we need our students to be in the final list of ESC as well as in the GATE PSU's examination. Okay, thank you guys. This was it. One more thing. Happy Holi to all my students. It's been an awesome. And please make sure you are playing safe Holi, because BARC exam is also nearer. So make sure you're just playing only a few hours for the Holi, and rest you can prepare your subjects, because that is also more important, because next year also Holi will be coming. So you can again enjoy Holi. Okay. So make sure you're not deviating from your path. Exam is nearby, and take care of your health. And I wish you from all the Grade Up team, happy Holi to all my students. This is it. Thank you guys. You can again, for any doubt, you can comment and post me, or you can post your doubt in the Grade Up platform. And that's it from my side. Thank you guys. You can prep smart, score better with Grade Up. Thank you. Bye-bye.